Hello friends, welcome back to my channel. This is your host Visha, and today I'm going to cover some topics which will be related to the hotel industry, as well as these topics will be related to the tourism industry. But let me tell you one thing, that in any case you have missed some topics related to salaries, related to type of colleges where you can get admission for doing your hotel management. So for that you can check my previous videos. So now coming for the today's video, I have the topics type of rooms and type of hotels. But in this video, I will cover the type of hotels. For the type of rooms, you have to watch my next video. So let's start with the video. The type of the hotels are divided into different categories. The first one category is on the basis of the size. Like small size hotels, they will have less than 25 number of rooms. Then you have medium size hotels, they will have 25 to 50 number of rooms. Then after that you have large number of hotels, they will have more than 100 number of rooms. Then you have very large hotels. The very large hotels will have more than 300 number of rooms. For more details related to the type of the hotels, you can also check the description below. Now coming to the second category, which will be according to the type of the star category, like 1-star, 2-star, 3-star, 4-star and 5-star hotels. So your 1-star, 2-star and 3-star hotels, they are small size hotels and they give you the less facilities. They are away from the city areas. That's why they come under the 1, 2 and 3-star categories. Then you have the 4-star and 5-star category hotels. These hotels, they give you the most luxurious facilities. They provide you more spacious rooms. They have very good architecture. They are also called as the heritage hotels. So these 4-star and 5-stars, they are the luxurious hotels which will have more than 4 or 500 rooms, and the 1-star, 2-star and 3-star hotels, they will come under the small size hotels. So now coming to the third category, which will be according to the type of the location, that where your hotel is located, according to that the different type of hotels are given. For example, the downtown hotels, they will be near to the city. Next is your suburban hotels, they are within the city centers. The next type, according to the location, will be resorts. Resorts will be near to the natural places, like they will be near to some forest, they will be near to some sea areas, near to the beaches, like this. The next type will be your flotels. Flotels are those which float on the sea, which float on the lake. For example, Shikaras in Kashmir. Then you have rotels. Rotels are those which rotate on wheels. Rotate on wheels means your trains, your luxurious trains. The luxurious trains which rotate on wheels in India are called as the Palace of Wheels, Maharaja Palace, like these. Next one is your motel. Motel has been derived from two words, motors and hotels. So the motels will be situated near to the highways only. And the last one category in this are the airport hotels. Airport hotels can be inside the airport also, or if they could be near to the airport also, so that people can easily take some accommodation in these hotels. The next category in the type of hotels will be divided according to the type of the clients. Which type of client is going to stay in the hotel, then according to that your hotels are divided. The first one is business or commercial hotels. Business or commercial hotels, they are like the normal ones where the tourist or any other guest can stay. The next one are your transient hotels. Transient hotels are mostly situated near to the sea where the ships arrive, near to the airports. Like I have told you, according to the location type, you have airport hotels. Similarly, the transient hotels are the same. They will be near to the railway station, near to the sea areas, near to the airports. Like this. Next type is your boutique hotels. Boutique hotels are small in size and they are very expensive hotels. In these hotels, every room is different from each other. The example for boutique hotels are Shahpura Bagh Palace, which is in Shahpura. Next is your residential hotels. Residential hotels are those where a guest or a person can stay from 1 month till 1 year or till 2 years. He can take accommodation for a longer period of time in the residential hotels. Next is your suite hotels. Suite hotels, again, they are very luxurious hotels. They give you the suite rooms, the presidential suite, junior suite, mini suite, like these. They give you the luxurious rooms and give you the maximum facilities which a hotel can give you. Next one is your casino hotels. Casino hotels are those where you get the gambling facilities inside the hotel only. For gambling, you don't have to go outside. You get a casino within the hotel. Those hotels are called as casino hotels. The next one is your bed and breakfast hotels. The concept of bed and breakfast hotel has been arrived from Europe. It is totally an European concept. Here, the owner of the house, he gives you only the bread and the breakfast, as he has converted his house into the guest house. There are few more types of hotels in this category, which you can check in the description below. So the last one category, which is for the type of hotels, is on the basis of the ownership. So the first one is independent hotels. Independent hotels will have only one owner, so they are called as the independent hotels. Then next you have the franchise hotels. In franchise hotels, what happens? You take the name of some big company and start your own hotel with the name of that company. Those hotels are called as franchise hotels. Then next category is the management hotels. In the management hotels, the owner of the hotel appoints one operator or one manager who take care of all the work of the hotel. So that those hotels will be called as the management hotels. And the last one are the timeshare hotels. Timeshare hotel is totally a new concept. In this type of hotels, you can buy some property for 2 weeks, for 2 months, for 2 years, and start selling the rooms of those properties. But after your contract is over, you have to hand over the hotel to the real owner. That is the timeshare concept. So that's all about today's video. If you want to have some more knowledge, you can check the description below and you can ask any questions in the comment section. And stay tuned for my next video where I will explain the type of the rooms. So I'll see you in the next video, and remember to subscribe our channel. Thank you.